So with that, we're going to take Q&A. I'm going to ask Ralph and Tom Kearns and Tom Lovelace to come back up. We've got a couple people with microphones around the room. And with that, we're about 9:45. We'll do probably about 10 minutes of Q&A or until... unless there aren't any more questions.
And as you receive the microphone, as we always tell you at these events, we do take your feedback very seriously. Your questions are important to us. So if you could give us your name and outlet, just so we can follow up on anything, we'll make sure you get everything you need. So David, start us off.
David Schmidt, Journal Register Newspapers. I'll ask the two data ones. When do they go on sale by model, and what are the prices, or when will the prices be coming?
The Optima will be available this fall, and pricing will be announced for at least a few weeks.
And what about the SX?
The SX will be available later in fall. So this is in the same time period? Not the same time as the 2.4.
Frank Alco for Scripps Howard News Service. How much does this car share with the Hyundai Sonata?
This we share the same platform with the Hyundai Sonata, and the engines also share, but there are many unique features on the Optima that we don't share with the Hyundai Sonata. For example, like the panoramic sunroof is unique, the cooled front seats, we have a driver seat memory system, and also a front passenger seat.
And also the design is not shared either. Our design is
touche.
Transmission, yes.
Two questions. You say you're not going to release pricing just yet, but do you expect to be able to charge more for this vehicle because it is, because of the design of it, and it is more stylish than what else is in the segment?
Charge more than what, Christy?
Than you did before, I guess. Are you moving away from value pricing?
Well, no, value is a critical piece of what we do. Value doesn't necessarily mean lowest price. Mm-hmm. It's what you get for the money. And as Ralph mentioned, we are a few weeks away from being able to share the specific pricing. Comparably equipped, it's going to be in the range of Sonata, content adjusted. But we have, we're shooting for under 20, and hopefully it's significantly under 20 to start.
Okay, and there was no talk of the hybrid. I thought that was going to be here at this event. So when is the hybrid coming out? And
the hybrid will be available early next year.
Okay.
Over on this side. Yeah. Somebody's pointing. Somebody over here. No.
Back. Hi, Aaron Gold from About.com. Unless you don't like my question, in which case I'm Jeff Glucker from Autoblog. the UVO system, you said it can pick tunes off of the hard drive. Will it also be able to select tunes off an iPod, like Sync?
Yes. Yes. Okay. It'll be able to access any device that you bring into the vehicle. So a USB, an iPod, the CD, the radio, as was mentioned. Anything else.
But can you do like a playlist, Jeff's music?
Yeah, exactly.
And will it read text messages?
Yes.
Okay, so it's similar functionality to the Ford system.
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Where is the bill?
Oh, hold on one second. All right.
State his name.
Jorge Keckling, AutomundoTVN.com. Where is it built, and how much is it sort of like an international Kia? Sorry to say, in the kind of effort in the world. Is it built only in the U.S. or is it built?
No, it's a global product, and the Optima is built in Korea.
It's built in Korea?
Yes. Thank you.
Hi, what kind of navigation GPS system is going to be in place?
Navigation.
Now,
what type of navigation system?
What do you mean? I'm not.
In terms of the brand, or are you looking for?
In terms of the technology, will it be integrated, sort of like OnStar? Will it be more like, the Ford products? I mean, I didn't really see anything in the presentation that spoke to that.
Okay.
I can answer.
Okay.
It's a full embedded navigation system, similar to the classic navigation. Right now, it's not connected. In terms of bypass car or have connectivity to it, it's something that we're working on for the future. But this release will have a classic navigation system, and fully embedded maps and voice.
Thank you.
Ian Hegwood, Parts and People, and Freelance. I have two quick questions. The first one is, how many Kia dealers are currently in the U.S.? I don't know that I have that number.
Well, we've approximately, it changes every day, Ian, but I mean, it's 735.
And also, I was wondering, is the Octa 50 state certified for emission?
Yes, it is. The Octa will have two types of emission for the 2.4. It will have a ULEV 2 and a SULEV.
Okay, and also is the wheelbase the same this time?
No, the wheelbase has actually increased by about 3 inches over the last generation.
Jordan, up here.
David Schmidt again. Do you anticipate this becoming the best selling of your vehicles, the largest selling of your vehicles?
Well, if you look at strictly the size of the segment, I would say that there's a terrific opportunity for us to grow. I'm going to fall short of saying it's going to be our top selling product. It's going to be one of them. It's clearly going to be one of our pillar vehicles, along with Sorento, which obviously is built right here in the U.S.
Frank Alcofer again. You listed the trunk volume. What's the passenger volume?
The passenger volume is 102 cubic feet.
First question from the other side.
Hi, Rebecca Leland from IHS Automotive, formerly Global Insight. I had a question on content globally. Do you see variations in different regions, or do you see the cooling seats and the heating seats being offered on a global basis as well?
The heated cool seats are offered globally in certain markets.
And all of these different systems, do you see similar content globally?
Well, the UVO system is unique to the U.S.
Okay.
Potentially could go to other markets, but each market evaluates their needs, and Korea is able to manage that by market.
Okay, thanks, Mike.
Jorge Gagling, AutomundoTVN.com. The power windows, are they automatic, up, down, front, rear?
The power windows are actually on the EX. They're automatic down and up for the front. Yeah, down and up on the front on the EX.
We'll go to Alan, then Ryan, then Frank. So Alan.
Have you completed your crash testing, and what rating do you expect this vehicle to get? And also, do you have a volume target? I don't think I heard one. What's your annual volume?
We do have. There's been no crash testing, and we expect the highest crash test rating for the Optima.
The second question was what the
annual volume.
lots. you know, we're right in the throes of trying to work out the next year's calendar planning. We're obviously going after as much production as we can get our hands on. And it will be one of the top two volume vehicles for us, I feel pretty certain. But in terms of an overall number, forgive me.
Ryan Bean with Automotive News. Roughly what share globally will be sold in the United States? I mean, you mentioned the production capacity for 2011, but about,
So the question, I'm sorry.
The question is roughly what percentage of global sales of the Optima will be from the United States?
You know, I'd have to get back to you on that one, Ryan, because I'm not sure what the other markets are projected to do. So maybe by lunchtime, maybe I'll have an answer for you. Okay.
Jordan DeFrank, right here.
Hi, Frank Washington with AboutThatCar.com. You've said in the past that the car is lower, wider, longer. How much lower, how much wider, and how longer? How much bigger is this car than it was? And the second question is, what's the capacity of the fuel tank?
The car is about 2 inches longer, about inch wider, and about inch lower. All the specs are in the USB drive. Additionally, the fuel tank is 18.5 gallons.
Valerie Menard with Decisive Auto Latino. Just as far as sales, where is the Optima currently in the midsize segment?
As far as selling, way down towards the bottom. There's lots of opportunity for us in this segment. That's why we're so excited about the car. In addition to all the left brain, you know, parts of the brand and the styling and everything, we see a great opportunity because a lot of what we deliver in terms of volume will be incremental to the brand, because we do very little right now in terms of exact share. I don't know. It's lots of opportunity.
All right.
Okay.
I think we're set. Happy to answer more questions along the way. Tom's coming to lunch with us.
Okay.
Michael, Ralph. Tom Kearns will not be with us, so he's here for a few minutes as we head towards the cars. If you have any questions for Tom, feel free. The cars are going to be out for...